Yes, I'm down. It's Christmas. And you can always tell when it's Christmas, I've got to be honest, you can. You can always tell when it's Christmas because dustbin men go, good morning! But what I like about Christmas is all the great films, especially that new one, Goldeneye. Because I don't know if you know this, and don't laugh, ladies and gentlemen, but I actually auditioned for the part of James Bond in that film. And tonight I would like to show you how it went, because it went something like this. Bond is back. 007 is Brian Conley. You alright, love? You alright? Right, can you get a mop for this woman, please? Alright, love, it won't be long, it won't be long. Sorry about that. Anyway. My name's Bond, James Bond. It was late Saturday night, I was at the office. Suddenly there was a knock at the door. Then I heard a gunshot. Stupid. It's the other way round, isn't it? Other way round.
Yeah, sorry, yeah.
Yeah, that's right, yeah. So anyway, I got to the room, I took the lift to the third floor. What was that?
An express lift.
Shut it! Don't get cocky. Anyway, I got to the door, I knocked on the door. I'm knocking. Hey, what am I knocking with, a sponge? I'm sorry?
We've lost a sound effect.
I'm sorry?
We've lost a sound effect.
I'm sorry?
There should be a sound effect here.
There should be a sound effect here, don't you, Jeremy? Look, come on in front of you. You're making me look stupid. What's up with you? Your nipple has gone hard, Tim. So anyway, what's the problem, Tim?
Well, there should be a sound effect.
No, your nipple has gone hard.
No, leave it.
There's 55 million people watching this show, including my mother, and you're making me look stupid. You're making the whole show. You're ruining the show, team. Ruining it.
Oh, no, I have to disagree with you there, Brian. Well, you see, I think this show falls between the ethereal qualities as demanded by the intellectuals and the cultural necessity of the urban lifestyle in which it grew. It's a show of participant elimination involving the assessment and placement of unconstrained information to various diverse categories, culminating in the show worthy of its superiority.
Yes! Shut it! Shut it! Shut it! They only like you. They only like you because you look like Postman Pat. Yes. Have you noticed all the kids on Postman Pat's round, they look like him. Have you ever noticed that? That makes you wonder what he's poking through the letterbox. Have you ever thought about that? So anyway, I got to the room, I knocked on the door. It's not working. My nipple's gone hard. It's not working. So I opened the door, and there in the doorway stood an undescribable creature. Half man, half beast, it stumbled towards me with blazing red eyes. Sweat dripping from its slimy, scaly body. It lifted itself up to its full height and even stoked through my nostrils. And with a fearful cry, shouted,
hello, my name's John Major.
Major.
It's a puppy!
I couldn't believe it. And in seconds, we were speeding along the road. It was at this moment I heard the police. Then suddenly I heard a howling wolf. Made a howling wolf. Howl! Or maybe a hyena's laugh.
Ha 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 ha!
You on drugs or something? Something. Could it have been an elephant's trumpet? Or was it a gay snake?
Hiss!
Shut it! I don't need Tim's sound effects, of that you can be sure. The only sound I want to hear is a cheer and some applause.